When did you start shaving your head? It looks good.
When did I start shaving my head? I shaved it. My first special, I had it shaved.
Really?
Yeah.
When I saw you in New York for the Patrice thing.
I'm glad you liked it. I see you losing the roof there in the back.
Yeah,
you'll be right there with me. We'll do a buddy cop show.
Exactly.
Right? Two balding old guys.
Exactly.
Going after some hairy criminal.
I'm not a big fan of Steve Jobs, personally.
What are you talking about?
I don't know. I just don't understand what the big deal was with that guy.
I don't get it. He's like Edison. I don't know. He invented all this stuff to everybody. What are you talking about?
But did he? Did he sit down and like, I'm going to invent the iPhone, and just sat there soldering, possibly welding, right? Didn't he have like a crew of guys helping him out?
Sure, maybe he did.
So why, when he went to those nerd fests, didn't he have like a chorus of scientists behind him who helped him out too? He walked out like he was Tesla. Like tapping into electricity.
I'm not with you.
I think he just kind of like told people what to invent. Like he just kind of came in like, I want my whole music collection in that phone. Get on it! And then all these nameless, faceless guys.
Yeah.
Made it happen.
Yeah.
And then they have the big nerd concert and he goes out there by himself. No belt, you know, sneakers on. I just didn't buy it.
Yeah, I'm a loner, man. I don't like people. So.
Yeah, you're not lying.
I don't.
Yeah, I know.
This Fifth Avenue during Christmas time, the thoughts that go through my head, I just want to chop that tree down and watch it land on people as I walk over their head.
No!
I do.
That was the holiday season. No.
You knew I wasn't going to stick to that.
I was trying to be happy.
When you took it out on Philly, because they were a bad crowd.
Oh, yeah.
Your famous rant,
yep.
Which you've since said you like Philadelphia, and that wasn't the issue. You were just giving...
People in Philly don't even remember. Basically, if you haven't seen it, I was doing a show for the Opie and Anthony radio program, and they had this show called The Traveling Virus, and we were doing these, like, 10,000-seaters, and we went to Philly, and they're notorious for booing people, and they booed the first guy off stage, and I went on, like, 3 hours after that. So by the time I got up there, it was a complete shit show. And I don't know. They started booing, and I snapped and decided I wasn't going to leave, and I just attacked everything that they loved. Yeah.
Can women be funny?
Yeah, of course. Will you guys just fucking grow up and just sit down and write your own horse shit and come up with it? Start your own fucking show. Have your own award show. Quit waiting around for other people to do shit for you. That's the fucking problem. If you guys had your own big club and I was standing outside of it, you'd never fucking let me in. I'd start my own shit. You guys got to start your own shit. You got brains in there, right?
Yes, absolutely.
So write your own shit and quit your fucking whining. We're all eating a giant shit sandwich out here. Nobody cares. I don't care. Well, when was the last time you went on stage and you killed so hard the person after you bombed? If you're fucking doing that on a regular basis, people are going to notice regardless of what you have between your legs.
You know what I feel bad for right now? McDonald's. I feel bad for them.
Why would you feel that?
Because they backpedaled. They allowed fat people to blame them. And it's just over. The second they made the salad, it was over. It was over. They said, you know what? It's our fault. It's our fault. It's our fault you're fat. It isn't. Everybody knows it's fattening. You don't order 50 sandwiches, right? But they're a business. If you order it, they're going to give it to you. That's not their fault.
Yeah, and you think that that's it right there. Once they invented
McDonald's
it,
is for when
they
you get,
admit it.
It's for kids and for when you get hammered. That's what it is. You go in there, you eat, you get the bread in you.
Yeah, at some point I was going to make a point here. That's why I keep looking at here, and I just realize I'm blocking myself out of the camera. I love that you have the jib camera for this, like it's an action movie. Let's swoop in at these two guys sitting in these unbelievably small chairs. I literally feel like I'm going to fall onto the floor. This is insane. You really went all out with the audience, though. They got full-size adult chairs. Are these like from the 20s before they had like horse tranquilizers in our food when everybody was like 5'1"?
Yeah. And nothing's making you mad? Nothing.
Things upset me. Yes. I don't know. I don't want to. Look, I fly a lot, and there's this whole new thing of generation of people that take their socks and their shoes off on the plane. You got to look at their smelly feet, and then they'll literally stand up and they will walk into a commercial airline bathroom. Yeah, use it and then walk and sit back down again.
That's not right.
Yeah, if I was a dictator, those people would be eliminated. Three times. I knew the second I saw the Christmas lights, I was like, I'm gonna bomb.
This is festive. This is it. You're allowed to do this.
It's not festive. It's fake. Okay? No. And you stick it in a box, and then you take it back out, and you staple it up next year. That's what you do.
I love this dude texting for the entire interview. It's just... Busted. It's just trying to keep the attentions on millennials. It's like impossible. Look at him. He's already got the chains. He's probably got his own record label. He's like making deals as we speak. He's got championship rings on. I don't know what you're doing, dude, but I want your life, man. You're crushing it.
So are you in the process?
I cannot get comfortable in this fucking chair. This is just like one of the worst things. This should be like in a museum. It's like the prototype. This is what... This was the awful level of comfort. We went from a log to this, and then eventually they got cushions. It's another guy looking at his phone. I swear to God. Dude, the day Jesus comes back, if he ever does, if he's even a real person, like 90% of people are going to miss it. They're going to walk right. He's going to be walking on water, and they're immediately walking by him. They're not even going to see it. Oh, yeah, and there's a drop-off in fame for Jesus at that point. Everyone was paying attention. Now no one gives a shit. Oh, there we go. No, but now this is like the ego one. Now I'm going to be sitting above you.
Yeah,
you got to come
man.
With two. It's fine. Sir, the one comedy through line that's working here is me shitting on this chair. Why would you take that from me? You're just totally going against the grain. I understand it. But you got on camera, so I think you get paid, even though this is online.
You see, Sugar Shea Mosley, one of the greatest boxers of all time, he's losing his championship belt in a divorce. It's like you're trying to break a man. Why does she want those? Right?
They
go with their shoes. No, and I love how when you get a divorce, all of a sudden it costs like 50 grand a month to give a kid Fruit Loops. Right? These guys, I'm telling you, there is an epidemic of gold digging whores in this country. And it is just not being addressed on any level.
Your character has a lot of tats.
Yeah.
Do you get those put on? You have a tat that says...
No. I have this. That's all my ink. I have this mic on, so...
Yeah, that's all right.
Be a f-ing gentleman and help me out with my coat.
Hey, Kodak, can you believe that marriage didn't work out? Gee, I can't believe your relationships don't work out.
We recently got a pit bull, which I know a lot of people don't like because they ate a couple of kids. I understand. They're great dogs, unless you're a bad owner. If you're a psycho, which I am, you can mess them up. I didn't realize that dogs feed off your vibes.
No.
Like if you're cool, if you're chill, they're chilling. If you're sleeping, they're sleeping. But if you're a psycho like me and you're watching the game on TV and you're screaming at the ref like, you gotta be shitting me! I didn't realize the dog was in the corner being like, yeah, you gotta be shitting me.
Being a mother is the hardest job out
there. Most difficult job in the... Oprah said that,
yeah. Has your opinion on that phrase changed at all since you've had a kid?
No. It's not the most difficult job on the planet. It just isn't. Dude, I did roofing in July. I almost, as a redhead, I almost died. There's people that work on like oil. What was that movie that guy made? The oil. What is it?
There Will Be Blood?
There Will Be Blood. Out in the ocean, they would drill. I can never remember the names.
Deepwater.
Mark Wahlberg
was there. Deepwater Horizon, yeah.
Those guys were working on an oil rig. The fucking thing blows up. They're on fire. They got to jump into water that's on fire. Salty water into their wounds. You got to swim out of that oil and fire and then tread water. Praying to God that the Coast Guard is going to get there before the sharks do. Now talk to me about a toddler. Oh, he was so fussy today. He wouldn't eat his peas.
Yo, what's up with all these white kids now walking around trying to act like they're like gangster rappers? It's irritating. It's like everywhere I go, man, I figure I'd just be here in the city where you got a good mix of people. You know, I'll be like in the middle of Kansas though. Like the whitest state ever. There'll be some howdy-doody looking white kid like me. You know, I'm thinking this is one of my peeps.
somebody I can have a conversation with. All of a sudden, she's like, yo, what's up, kid? What's up, kid? I just want to be like, nothing much, Brad. You know, you keeping it real in Wichita? How the fuck are you going to be a gangster in a state, say, like Nebraska? You know, wouldn't you be like all hardcore about your crop? Just in there, yo, shit was crazy, you know what I'm saying? My fucking corn wasn't growing, my fucking scarecrow was tipping over and shit, you know what I'm saying, son? I just want to be like, dude, you're white. Go to the Gap, give into it. Buy some Dockers and come home.
I've been going to gun stores and...
Oh, my God.
And these rednecks are all telling me the same thing because I didn't grow up with guns. So they're just going, all right, you never had a gun, you want to get yourself a shotgun. It's got a great spread. That's what they keep saying. It's got a great spread. You don't even got to aim. You got a problem, you just sort of whip around.
You get the guy, right?
I'm sitting there, I'm like, dude, I just want to shoot the guy. I don't have to do, like, a bunch of drywall work and, like, reframe my diploma. So I didn't think Lance owed anybody. He didn't do anything to me. You know what he did for me? He raised $500 million for cancer research. That's what that lie did.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was great. Everybody had the bands on. Remember the bands?
Yeah. Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
That blocked out the sun,
yeah.
Right?
You know, it wasn't to block out the sun.
No risk cancer?
Yeah.
Now, the whole thing was annoying, and I hated how Oprah was interviewing him and acting like she was dumbfounded that this guy would do this. Like, she's been in show business for 35 years, and she can't, like, wrap her head around some guy doing whatever it takes to get to the next level. Didn't she, for the first 5 years, have, like, midgets who wanted to bang their mailman's boyfriend? And she didn't want to do it. She didn't want to do it, but she didn't have the power to say no, so she wrote it out. And then when she could make a good decision, she did a show. But she stood on the heads of those little people for 5 years until she got... And then she's sitting there across from this guy, like... Like, so how could you? You know exactly what he's doing.
Oh, not hamburger assistant again. Why can't Mom make dinner?
Ask her. She's the one who abandoned her post. Now after doing all the lady work, I gotta leave to go do some man work. And is anybody gonna get me flowers and tell me I'm beautiful? No. No one's out there marching for old Frank Murphy. He just watches the sands of his miserable life gather at his feet while his wife, the modern woman, throws on a pantsuit every morning and just... There's my worker bee.
What is your go-to dance move when challenged?
Waiting for the director to say cut.
That was my go-to dance move.
Well, I'll tell you, when I saw my kid, it wasn't... I didn't have, like... Everybody was like, you're gonna burst down crying, you're gonna blah, blah, blah. I was, like, scared of it. Like, I was just sitting there like, hey, yeah, buddy. Like, I didn't want to touch it. And then, like, afterwards, they give it to me, and I'm hanging with her for the first time, and I'm feeling nothing. And I literally put my head down on the bassinet. I'm going, oh, my God, I'm a serial killer. Like, I don't feel things.
So, Bill, do you Google yourself? Because I was, like, Googling the show.
No. God knows.
I was Googling the show.
I get trashed enough on Twitter. Do you know when I did the show last night? This is how, like the millennials are, right? Somebody, I was wearing this exact same thing. You know, I'm on the road, so I got a nice stain on my shirt. So I was wearing this exact same thing. I go on Twitter, and somebody wrote, you know, Bill Burr last night dressed like an out-of-shape Jerry Seinfeld.
What?
So, like... Yeah, I wrote back. I can't say what I wrote back. I wrote back.
You did?
You so-and-so. Yeah, it's like, why don't you heckle me when you're there?
On the show Crashing, very funny show, you play yourself.
Oh, yes.
Is it hard playing yourself as an actor?
No. That's what I've been doing my entire limited acting career. Like, real actors are like Anthony Hopkins, where he played that serial killer in Silence of the Lambs.
Hannibal Lecter, yeah.
Yeah, and then, like, the next move, that should have ended his career. Like, you should never have been able to see him as anybody else. And then the next movie, he played, like, John Quincy Adams, and he was literally John Quincy Adams. My buddy saw this thing one time, John Travolta was talking about, like, just the walks. He's like, Vinnie Barbarino walked this way, Vincent Vega walked this way, like you know, whatever. The guy from Get Shorty walks this way. And I just remember hearing that going like, dude, all my characters walk like me.